we have a word?
Let me guess. He's done something crazy.
Show me again, I'm gonna break your neck.
Why are you here?
I don't think you believe me.
Come on, man. I had a run-in with a space engine.
This fucking guy is crazier than the rest of us.
What the fuck was that?
That's the thing that killed my men.
Alien.
Welcome to another iRock challenge game. Today I'm playing a 1v1 against an extreme AI, but this extreme AI has plus 200% handicap, whereas I'm on 100%, so it's going to be an interesting match. Let's fast forward through the Dark Age and get to the action. It's the standard build for me. And with 200% handicap, my AI opponent should be flying through to Feudal Age, and there he goes, already at Feudal. Everything's faster and stronger for the plus 200% handicap player. So I'm having to fight with a massive disadvantage. Gone forward with two bills to wall up my opponent's gates, but I'm not sure if that's going to keep him locked in, because he's already in Castle Age. Already in Castle Age with some crossbows. Monkeys out and about. And I'm just distracting the crossbows there with my scout. Sacrifice my scout so I could come over here and build a gate. Unfortunately, he has one villager outside. But I have reached Castle Age, which means I can start setting up some crevasse fortifications. However, my opponent is, with that one build, going to put up an archery range. And I'm coming, down there to build another archery range. I'm only coming forward with more bills now. So he's going to have army outside his base. It's going to make it a bit difficult for me. I have my first crepost up, so that would be helpful to take down some of his military. Give me a bit of room to breathe. Second crevasse is going up over here. You can see how strong crossbows were against Conic. One crossbow took down Conic with a little bit of help from another one. So he's forcing me off some of my gold near his base. Build more crevasse to just try to get a little bit of safety. And now that rams are out, and now I'm going to need mangonels. And his skirms are very resilient. Fortunately, the rams are distracting all the crevasse fire. But at least I do have two crevasse up on this side. And I'm getting a second crevasse up on this side. I really need to keep him trapped, otherwise I have no chance. Look how sturdy these rams are against my mangonels. And look how fast they produce. They are literally flying out of that one-seat workshop. And also, even the buildings have extra HP, so they're very sturdy. Researching capped ram, that's dangerous. And look how much damage these buildings soak up. As, yes, he's in Imperial Age, so he's got a hit point boost there, as well as being able to research capped ram. And looks like they're now siege rams. He broke through, and he also took down my crevice. Let's slow down the action a little bit. Oh, that's a big shot from his onager. He has onager, I only have mangonels. Still trying to take down the siege workshop. And what his onager takes down my mangonel. Not even the onagers are quite sturdy, able to withstand more than two shots from the crevice. I won't be cooking Imperial for a little bit, and at the moment I'm just focusing on trying to take down the siege workshop. To me, that's key. This lone villager is still producing things out here. And unfortunately, somehow this area of the wall was opened, and now villagers are flooding out. One villager down here. So, I'm going to want to be wanting to make some conics to boost stop to them. And look how strong the onager is with that repair bill. These conics have chased down almost all the bills that have come out. Still two bills over here. Siege workshop still over 1500 HP. It is very hard to take down these buildings. The 200% handicap. And I'm still in Castle Age. Looks like it's forever castle for me at this stage. At least for quite a while longer. But there are two enemy bills over here mining gold. Looks like there's another enemy bill over here. My gold, so they're everywhere. Siege workshop down under 1000 HP for the first time. Micro dodging the onager shots. Unfortunately, I lost the mangonel, but shouldn't matter, hopefully. This will be the last onager. Yeah, that will be the last onager. now I can focus on cleaning up these bills. Still one bill over here. There's three bills over there. So this one villager is setting up quite a little production center. Well, I'm just going to strengthen my position here and try to get back on this gold. Villagers still flooding out, but not like trickling out, but I'm taking them out. And I'm starting to raid with conics to try to weaken this production if it's possible. Still, I'm in Castle Age. Still look like staying in Castle Age for a long time. I'm getting a good raid in, but got a lot of villages still. 46 bills. At least I do have the eco lead, but it's not really an eco lead when he has 200% handicap. So if I can idle much of that eco, then I might just be able to get the eco lead. Shots this archery range is taking from 3 mangonels, still on over 1500 HP. Strength of these handicapped buildings is insane. Still, I'm forever castle, but this is interesting. Moving forward, I think I'm going to move into his base for the first time. Will hopefully also put a stop to villagers coming out of this hole. I don't have the stone for enough trepos, unfortunately, to safeguard these mangonels, but with some conics, should be able to protect them, as well as the trepos fire. How strong is this TC? 5,800 hit points, now it's just even 5,000. So I have the eco lead now, 60 bills to 22. And it definitely looks like I have the upper hand. Let's assess the situation. This production center is still fairly strong. Still no red presence over here. And the bills that wandered over here to take this stone, now coming back, I imagine get killed one way or another. Yeah, not a lot of production now for the predator. Looks like I have seriously harmed his ego. Yes, he's basically out of food and gold. Bills aren't really doing anything. Basically all idle. And now they're coming to try to escape, I guess. That would be very successful. the hem of the TC goes down. And now my siege can try to take down one of these other huge buildings. But I'm going to come in and build a Krepos just to secure complete control of the base. Be down to three villages. Just managed to get a vill over this side finally and build another TC. Probably came from the vills that were on this mine here. And Uni has three villages. I'm not sure where the other two are gone. One bill over here, and I've discovered this town center. Perhaps saw there was one bill in this town center. And the creditor is now begging, I'm weak, please do not attack me. Well, he certainly is weak. Only one bill left. Now I have five mangonels. We'll see how quickly they can take down this TC. Soaking up a lot of making our fire. But it will go down. Slowly but surely. And now I've got a ram out, so that'll two rams that'll help to speed things up. And I've picked up to Imperial. So this is GG, it's been GG for a while. And I'm just using some conics to keep a watch on this TC. That I didn't even have worried, he's only got the one villager.
Do you know what my job description is? I'm in acquisitions. I look up and I catch what falls out of the sky.
What's on the ship?
About the mission. Did you see anything unusual?
It's above our pay grade.
Do I get a cookie now?
GG. Yeah, the last portion of the game, he was pretty weak, as he said. But it was a huge battle for a long time. He had the economy lead, despite my having more villagers for a lot of this time. Look at the KD, 5.97, 352 kills to 59 losses. And he had a massive military advantage, but he was just out of position. He was stuck inside his base. I did take over eventually, but it took a long time to wear down that strong, resilient 200% handicap base. Economy? Yeah, he mined much more wood and food as expected, but because he didn't have many bills and a lot of them were idle at the end, I got much more gold and stone especially. Technology, way faster to feudal and castle. That's the eco speed of the 200% handicap working there. Some ridiculous times. Even the imperial age time was fairly quick. Society. Well, I don't think there were many castles, only one castle for me at the end, so I can build the traps. There we go. That was my 1v1 versus the extreme 200% handicap AI. I hope you enjoyed. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.
I think you know what is on the ship. The ultimate predators.
Light him up!
We may die.
We're still here.